Hi, it's again Roomfleet, and this is our third video. Today we will talk about Redder ARPA. This video will be quite short, but I hope it will be useful. So, some general words about Redder. Redder is radio detection and ranging, and you will find in the vessel X-band or 3 cm 9 Hz and S-band 9 cm and 3 Hz radars. What is ARPA? It's automatic radio floating aid, and it's necessary to recognize that ARPA and Redder is actually two different units. Yeah, what I mean? Actually, Redder is antenna, display, everything what you see physically. Yeah, this is your radar, it's transmitter, receiver of the radio waves. And ARPA, let's say, to simplify, it's like a special program, computer program that help you to calculate the CPA, TCPA and so on. As you know, before ARPA was implemented on the vessels, it was necessary to make calculation manually. Yeah. But for the moment we have ARPA, so it's really simplified the life of the navigators at sea and make the navigation much more safer. With the help of ARPA, we calculate the speed of the target, course, true course of the target, and as I said already, it gives you CPA, closest point of approach, and TCPA, the time of closest point of approach. Actually, from the radar you can take the bearing distance to any target, to the shore, calculation of your position, check your GPS and so on. 3 cm radar is compulsory on board because that one is working on the same frequency that SART, search and rescue transporter. So there are some difference between the 3 and 10 centimeters radars. It's of course range, operation in different weather condition, ability to show small targets, and as I said already, showing of the SART signal. Actually, the range generally depends on the power of the transmitter, so you cannot say 100% that 3 cm will show you less range or 10 cm will show you the less range. Actually, everything comes from the power of the transmitter, and in the reality, if you will have the low power, it doesn't matter what you use, 3 or 10 cm. It will be limited by the transmitter only, and operational in different weather condition. Actually, it already depends from the length of the radio wave. Yeah, that's why we talk about 3 cm and 10 cm radar, and that's mean the length of the transmitting wave. So, as you understand, ability of the longer wave is to come through the some small obstructions, and it will be not so occurred by the, let's say, snow, by the rain, or even some small boats and so on. So actually, let's say 10 centimeters will not show you the proper picture of the small targets what will be around. With the 3 centimeters, another 3 centimeters working in the another way, so on the picture, on the radar, on the display, you will see a lot of echo sounds that actually you will not find on the 10 centimeters radar. So it's come about ability of showing of the small targets, and as well any radar has limitation, and limitation you can find in the it will be prescribed in the manual of the manufacturer. Any radar limited on the horizontal and vertical angle, and any radar will be limited by the horizontal and vertical angle. What does it mean? It's actually ability of the radar to show the two different targets on the some small distance between them. Let's say I will try to make a picture of that one. Let's say this is our minimum angle that the radar able to show two targets. This is two targets, like two separate targets. Yeah, if this angle will be smaller, let's say over here, so on this distance radar already cannot show these two targets like two separate targets. I hope you understand the idea. we will come to the next slide about abbreviations and actually types of showing information on the display. So you can choose as an operator a true motion, and you will see TM two letters, relative motion, and RM on the display, and relative motion true. So on the display will be RMT as well. For what we are using all of these different types of showing information here on the radar, and where it's better to use all of that. Let's say true motion, it's really useful in the during the pilotage and navigation close to the shoreline, because in this motion all vectors of the speed and trails will be shown in the true, yeah? That's why it's called true motion. And the plus of that one, you will see the buoys, the shoreline, like spots that are staying in their fixed position, yeah? So all targets what are really moving in reality, you will see like they're moving, like they have vector, and all the target what is not moving, you will see like a stable spot, small targets on the display. Relative motion is opposite way, so as you understand, if you will switch on that one near the shore during the pilotage, the shoreline will have will show the speeds, the even buoy will have the speed, yeah, it will be opposite to our course and our speed, but in some circumstances it can make misunderstanding in your head, yeah, when you're looking on the small echo and you're thinking maybe it's a boat, but in reality it's buoy and it's stable, it had no any speed. So of course preferable to use the true motion during the navigation with the pilot and near the shore, and relative motion true, so it's optional what's happening in this variant of the showing information. In relative motion true, your vessel will be still in the relative motion, so all calculations will be made like your vessel is the start of the calculation, like you have zero speed, yeah, but the vectors and the speed of the targets around and the trails as well will be showing in the true mode. So as for me this type should be used only if you're sure you understand what is going on under the radar, you have some at least small experience to do not mix up in your head what is going on, yeah, because at the same time on the display, thanks to technologies, thanks to the ARPA, it's possible now you will see your vessel in the relative motion and the all vectors around will be in the true. So if you're really sure, if you really understand what is going on, if not, better ask somebody one more time on the vessel, or try to, when you will have not so heavy traffic, try to monitor what is going on during all of these types of showing of the display of the radar. And only practice will really give you real information how it's going on. So practice, and one more time practice. And on the next slide, why I choose this picture, because on this picture really quite simple to understand what is going on, how ARPA is working actually, and what we need, what it's doing here. So you can see that origin target, when we start monitoring in the position over here with the O letter, and the actual target, let's say it doesn't matter over here, it's 6 minutes, 12 minutes, we just trying to catch the main thing, how actually ARPA working and how it's making calculation, yeah. And the next position, you know, the target is in the position A over here as well. We have our vessel that in the center of this circle, yeah, it's over here, and our course, let's say we are looking strictly on the north. So what we can do from this one, first of all, if you will make the line from O to A and continue that one, you see the blue vector, you can get the CPA, and it will be the closest point of approach, the distance from the cross, red cross over here, to center of our vessel, it will be the closest point of approach. And as well we can find the true speed and true course of the target what we are monitoring, how we can do this one. We need to make a new vector from the OW, what it's actually will be. OW, this is the way, I mean, the speed of your vessel. And when you put this vector, as I said, to the point O, you can get the actual speed of the target. How we can do this one? From the point W to the A, we make one more vector, and vector WA will be the real course and the real speed of our target, what we are monitoring. So actually, as you see, nothing difficult, and it's really simple explanation of this thing. If you like to get more explanation about thematic, how to actually find the course of few targets, how to find CPA, TCPA, I mean manually on the CPA, TCPA manually. So just please write down this one in the comments and we will try to spend a bit more time for this thing. But for the moment, I believe we finish. As I said, it will be quite a short video. Next time we will talk about GMDSS, and see you next time.